Well, this is Bertha. This is Madeline, Beverly, and Ruth. And Midge is over there. Who have I left out? These girls play Mahjong every Thursday night.
Why, you left out yourself, Melissa Manchester. Flowering young pop music rising star from Manhattan by way of the Bronx. Today is Melissa's birthday, 24 years old. Blowing bubblegum in the back seats of limousines, rushing from interview to interview. A singer, a songwriter, a musician, all the commodities to climb the charts, to become a part of the galaxy in the pop music world of the 70s. So dance with us, Melissa. Rub up against our shoulders. Take us to a party. Promoters and record dealers throw a birthday party for Melissa the night before her Minneapolis concert. Trying to make it in the male-dominated record industry, Melissa is surrounded by what she calls the soft, creative businessmen, like her manager and husband, Larry Bresner. Larry was running a health food store in New York when he met Melissa. Now he says, Melissa has the dreams, and I carry them out. Vinny Poncia, high-powered, soft-touch record producer from Los Angeles. Vinny has written music for Ringo Starr. Now he's on Melissa's team. And the heaviest of them all, Clive Davis, president of the Arista record label, the record mogul who first signed Janis Joplin for Columbia, author of a new behind-the-scenes bestseller on the music business, now Melissa's boss, and the power behind her third album. It's Sunday, 7 hours before the concert. A rent truck full of drums, guitars, keyboards, wires, mics, and other sound equipment is moved on stage at Orchestra Hall. Melissa arrives 4 hours before the concert and is impressed with the new orchestra hall, but it was not built for amplified music, and it takes 3 hours to reach a compromise.
It's just too many broken people afraid to take a stand. It's just too many lonely people living in a house divided by loneliness.
Is that the monitor?
And feedback. I never understand.
Okay, we'll run it one more time. Just the instruments, just too many people. Okay?
First of all, my earliest influence, as far as music goes, is classical music. Because my father is a bassoonist with the Met Opera. So by the time I got to be 16, I had been exposed to classical music, to jazz, to rock and roll. I would like to get involved in choreography, perhaps get involved in directing, perhaps get involved in acting, to study acting, to become a legend while I'm alive.
Hi,
pretty good. That's what I figured. It sounds pretty good out here, too. I mean, I don't know what the big problem in this hall is, but so far I haven't heard it.
Yeah. Something's come over me at last. Ooh, sweet darling, long as you stay by me, I'm happy.
It's more and more important to have that, to be able to summon up positiveness, because that becomes your strength. A, from what you're doing because you're enjoying it. B, from the fact that you're surrounded by people that you genuinely love and have a tremendous affection for.
Filled the hall twice that night, an attentive audience that gave Melissa good energy. Long applause, standing ovations. She gave them 11 songs and 3 encores. The box office grossed $25,000. $6,000 went to Melissa and the band, the rest to the hall, the promoters, the equipment rental, the stagehands, all the others who help you make it in the pop music business. We're gonna